Okay, so we're going to discuss today the fundamentals of immunology with the blood bankers. So this topic will be discussing a short discussion regarding the basics of your immunology. So immunology forms part as a foundation for your blood banking because, of course, here we're dealing with the blood and the blood products that would be involving here the antigen antibody and all of that. Okay, so we'll not be dealing much of this one, so we just have to go through as immediate as that. Okay, so we have here the immune system. So let's speak about the immune system. Okay, immune system here are actually involves the different cells and molecules and the different organs, system in our body that try to work together primarily for the for the elimination of the harmful pathogen that enters our body. So we classify our immune system as either innate or another name for that is your natural immunity versus your acquired or your adaptive immunity. Your natural, the innate immunity would have the properties of, number one, it's non-specific. It's non-specific because it tries to react to whatever harmful pathogen that enters your body. Hindi siya namimili. And this natural immunity is the immunity that's being conferred here by our body upon birth. And most likely that one came from our parents or from our mother. Okay, so your natural, the innate immunity includes here the first line of defense, which are your physical barrier, and your second line of defense, which includes your cellular and biochemical defenses. Acquired adaptive immunity, on the other hand, so this is a type of the immune system or immunity wherein we try to develop that one as the product of exposure. And therefore, it confer memory, and it's also confer here specificity, because this one is already acquired here after a second exposure. Then you develop that one on the first exposure. So what's involved here in your acquired or adaptive immunity involves here your B lymphocytes, which are involved in your humoral immunity, and your T lymphocytes are involved here in the cell-mediated immunity. Okay, then we have here the lymphoid organs, classifying here the primary and your secondary lymphoid organs. The primary lymphoid organ is a site of your antigen independent maturation because it is where your T cell and your B cell try to mature even without meeting up with your antigen or your pathogen. So your primary lymphoid organs include your T, or for the T cell, that's your thymus. And for the B lymphocyte, that's your bone marrow. As they try to mature, they migrate to your secondary lymphoid organs. This includes your spleen, your lymph nodes, your mouth mucosa-associated lymphoid tissues, or gut-associated lymphoid tissues. The secondary lymphoid organs are actually the trapping site of your antigen. It's the meeting site of your antigen and your mature T and mature B lymphocytes. And therefore, this is the site of your antigen dependent maturation process. It's antigen dependent because your T and the B lymphocytes try to proliferate and become immunocompetent as they try to meet with your antigen. Dito, sa primary lymphoid organ, hindi sila nag-meet ng antigen, but they try to mature. Dito naman, nagmamature sila by meeting up with your antigen. Okay, then we have here your antibody response or antibody production. We classify this one as the primary and the secondary antibody response. The primary antibody response is usually occurring here during the first exposure of the antigen or during the first entry of the antigen in your body. So basically, once your antigen or your pathogen enters your body will, immune system cells and different reactions will help here then to eliminate the antigen in your body, leading to the production of your antibody. So we have here the stages, the lag phase. So pag ditong lag phase, there's no antibody production. So pag nag-increase ng ating antibody production, na become here the log or the logarithmic phase. In the steady state pattern, the plateau state here, state wherein your antibody production is equal to antibody degradation. Decline is a stage wherein your antibody here try to increase, this is characterized by increased antibody destruction, namamatay na siya. What you produce here during the primary response would be the IgM antibody. Secondary immune response or secondary antibody production is characterized also here by having the same stages, lag phase, logarithmic phase, plateau states, and steady state part, and decline stage. And what you produce here in the secondary response would be the IgG antibody. Okay, another difference between your primary and secondary immune response with antibody production, I mean, during the primary antibody production response, you have here a longer lag phase. It's longer because again, this is the first encounter with the antigen, so medyo nag-orient pa lang silang dalawa. Unlike dito, secondary, pag secondary antibody response, this is occurring here on the second exposure. Since second exposure na ito, nakilala niya na, na-meet na niya during the primary response. Since kilala niya na, wala na masyadong orientation, and that would already directly involve here the production of your antibody as with the IgG antibody na. And therefore, the primary antibody response would have a longer lag phase compared with your secondary antibody response, which is characterized here by a shorter lag phase. Okay, then we have here your antigen and antibody. So, antigen or your immunogen are substances we try to stimulate your antibody production. Okay, so we have here the characteristics of a good antigen. So, number one, it should have a bigger structure. Another one, it should have a very complex structure. The bigger the size, the complex the structure, the more immunogenic, the more foreign it is, the more it can stimulate immune response. Okay, so another one, we have the term epitope. Epitope here serve as the binding site of your antibody sa antigen. Kung ito sa antigen, meron siyang epitope doon. Doon nagbabind sa ating antibody. Another one, we have your immunoglobulin. Other name for that are your antibodies. So we have here different classes of your immunoglobulin, IgM. This is the biggest one. It's a pentamer. There are five binding site for that. There are five monomer unit in one of your IgM antibody, making that one as a complete antibody. Pag sinabing complete antibody, because of the bigger structure, bigger molecules here would allow it to have an agglutination reaction immediately. IgG antibody, consider here to be an incomplete antibody. So, maliit siya ng antibody. So, pag para magkaroon ng agglutination reaction, dalawang IgG antibody dapat ang naka-bind sa ating RBC. And that's why it's being cross-linked here by your anti-human globulin for that to have an agglutination reaction. IgD, IgE, and IgA. Pero ang usually ginagamit sa blood banking lang natin or what's being involved in the blood banking would be your IgM saka IgG antibodies lang. Okay, now we have here the term affinity and avidity. So, when we speak about the affinity here is the binding, interactive binding force that drives your antigen to able to be bind with your antibody. So, what's in the antigen would be the presence of the epitope. And in antibody, you have the paratope. So, pag nagbind silang dalawa, that become your affinity. Okay, so like for example, kung ito si antigen, ito si antibody, ang force of attraction for them to bind is your affinity. Pag sinabi namang avidity here is the total sum of the antigen-antibody complex. Kung hindi pa sila nag-bind, ano pinagkaiba? Pag hindi pa sila nag-bind, kung antigen nito sa antibody, pag hindi pa sila nag-bind, ang force na mag-attract sa kanila, in order for them to bind, that's your affinity. Pero pag nag-bind na sila, nag-form sila ng antigen-antibody complex, ang force nilang dalawa ng complex na yan, that's your avidity. Okay, then we have here your reaction. Okay, the zone of your reactions. So we have here the pre-zone, you have the zone of the equivalence, and we have your post-zone. Okay, the zone of the equivalence, it is where we are able to visualize your antigen antibody reaction. Ito yung area wherein your antigen and your antibody are equal in the concentration. And therefore, you're able to visualize here the occurrence of your agglutination. Nakikita natin nagkakaroon ng agglutination because again, the concentration of your antigen antibody are equal. And that's in the zone of the equivalence. Your pre-zone, on the other hand, is the area where you have your more antibody, the zone of your antibody excess. So you have more antibody compared with your antigen. So pag madami ang antibody mo compared with your antigen, do not expect to have an agglutination reaction kasi hindi sila balanced. Post-zone, on the other hand, is the area where you have an antigen excess. And therefore, ganun din, it would have also here the false negative reaction. Sa pre-zone natin, since madami kang antibody, all you need to do is to dilute your sample for this. Pag dilute mo siya sa bababang level ng antibody natin or concentration ng antibody, it might eventually result to your agglutination reaction. But in the post-zone, your antigen excess, wala tayong magagawa na doon. It can't really have a visible agglutination reaction. And always, when you're doing your agglutination reaction, make sure that one is in the zone of the equivalence. Again, the zone of the equivalence, you have concentration of your antigen and concentration of antibodies are equal. Okay, now we have here the different factors which might affect agglutination reactions. Okay, so again, pagkakaroon ka lang ng agglutination reaction, what is being involved as a reactants in your agglutination reaction includes your antigen and your antibody. So, dapat dalawang sample natin. Okay, so basically, your RBC, okay, by nature, they are negatively charged because they have this shellac acid or you call it one as your zeta potential. Okay, because of that, RBC in our peripheral circulation are not able to stick to one another. Kaya ngayon, ang blood natin, they are free-flowing in our peripheral circulation. They are not sticking to one another kasi pag nag-stick sila sa isa't isa, magkaklat, mamamatay tayo. But it's not happening in our blood because again, they have this negative charge, the so-called here, the zeta potential, that would allow the RBC here to push to one another. Okay, to allow agglutination reaction, you need to destroy the zeta potential. Okay, basically, we have here for an agglutination reaction to occur, then you need to destroy the zeta potential in allowing the RBC here to become close to one another para pag lumapit silang dalawa, you're able to visualize the presence of your agglutinase. So, in order to do that one, so we have here several factors here that try to affect your agglutination reactions. So, basically, for that to undergo here agglutination reaction, then you need to destroy the zeta potential. The first one, we have here your centrifugation. So, centrifugation could eventually allow a closer proximity of the RBC. And even reactants between your antigen antibody after subjecting your reactants here to your high speed and time. So, ang mangyari after that one, your reactants will try to concentrate to the bottom of the tube. So, wala silang choice but to be closer to one another, it would enhance your agglutination reactions. Another one, we have here the effect of the pH. The usual pH for your antigen-antibody reaction occurring here at the pH of 6.5 to 7.5. Except for the following blood groups, we have your anti-M, anti-SP, PR1. They are more reactive at a pH of lower than 6.5. So since acidic ito, so you need to acidify your sample in order for them to be reactive. Okay, pag hindi mo siya ma-acidify, even if these antibodies, blood groups antibodies are present, it will not cause your agglutination reaction or able to miss out an agglutination reaction. So you need to acidify that one, like for example, you can add an acid here, 0.1 hydrochloric acid, so to acidify your serum sample. Another factor we try to determine here, agglutination reaction, we have here the temperature. As with the temperature, so IgM antibodies are cold reacting, saline reacting antibodies. IgG antibodies are warm reacting antibodies. So they are reactive at 37 degrees Celsius. Since your 37 degrees Celsius here is your body temperature, so delicado ito if they are present, especially during the blood transfusion. So it becomes a clinically significant antibodies. So we have also here classification of your blood groups as according to your IgM and IgG antibodies. Again, all IgM antibodies are cold reacting antibodies. They are saline reacting antibodies. Example, the blood groups which are IgM antibodies, we have your ABO blood group, your M, your N, your P, your I, the Lewis, and we have also your Lutheran blood group system. For the IgG naman, so this includes your RH, your KID, okay, your GKA, JKB, these are your KID blood group. Also the KEL, we have the K, the bigger K and smaller K, the Duffy blood group system, FYA, FYB, the SS and the U blood group system, plus your Lutheran B. Lutheran B belongs to your IgG blood group, IgG type of antibodies. Remember here, the IgG antibodies are clinically significant antibodies. Another factor that is responsible here for the weaker expression, sometimes we're able to have here a weak reactions because that antibody shows here a dosage effect. Kasi having dosage effect, that antibody will be reactive only here for the antigens which try to show here a homozygous expression. It will not be reactive, ganun ka reactive if your antigen here is homozygous for that. I mean, magiging reactive lang siya pag heterozygous ang kanyang antigen expression. It will not be reactive here or will have your weak reaction if your antigen is in the homozygous expression. Sample for that, your M saka N blood group system, they are antithetical partner to one another. So, palagi silang magkasama. Like for example, ito ang phenotype ni antigen natin. We have M positive saka N positive. Another example, M positive saka M positive. So, may antibody tayo na anti-M. Ang anti-M na to, kung ito ang for example, ang antigen natin sa sample natin, ito ang antibody mo, anti-M. So, we have here M positive, N positive. So, magkaiba silang dalawa versus this one na dalawang M. So, this one, antibody anti-M, is more reactive dito because this is a heterozygous expression of your M. Compared naman sa homozygous expression of your MM. Kasi, bakit siya dito reactive? Kasi dito lang, isa lang ang M natin. So, your antibody would be able to concentrate reacting to this one. And like this one, mahahati ang kanyang reaction. Giving this one a weaker expression. So again, ito yung mga blood groups natin we try to show a dosage effects. MN, SS, your RH, your KID, your Duffy, blood group system. So, again, they are more reactive if your antigen is in the heterozygous expression more than your homozygous expression. Okay, then we have here the reaction, the enhancement media, and potentiators. So, when you are doing, for example, your antiglobulin test or even like when you're doing, for example, compatibility testing, there are three phases or stages. The first stage, we have here the immediate spin. So, immediate spin, you just need to have your reactants lang, like your donor blood, your donor's red cell suspension, plus the recipient na serum. I-mix mo lang siya. Then, after that one, you try to perform immediate spin, or centrifuge mo lang siya. And after immediate spin, try to observe here kung may agglutination reaction or wala. If nagkaroon ng agglutination reaction during that phase, as early as that immediate spin, what you are identifying here will be the presence of your IgM antibody. Again, why IgM antibody? Because again, IgM antibody are very big antibody. So, it would immediately react or allows agglutination reaction with your and with your red cell antigen kung talagang present ang ating IgM antibody kasi malaki siya na antibody. Another one, after that, you could proceed. Pag wala siyang agglutination reaction, you can proceed with incubation at 37 degrees Celsius. Pag nagkaroon ng agglutination at 37 degrees Celsius here, so swarm reacting antibodies ang ating madidetect, it will signify the presence of your IgG antibodies. Then we have your antiglobulin phase with addition of your anti-human globulin. So, pag nag-react ito sa anti-human globulin phase, it will still signify the presence of your IgG antibodies. Now, we have here the specific na mga enhancement media or your potentiators. The first one, we have here the saline or the NSS. Again, dito siya, it will detect sa'yo the IgM antibody in the immediate spin. Anti-human globulin, so anti-human globulin is a reagent we try to enhance agglutination reaction by cross-linking ang dalawang RBC may na naka-attach na IgG antibodies. So, because remember again that the IgG antibodies are very small or incomplete antibody. Kung mag-isa lang siya, hindi mo makikita ang agglutination reaction with just your naked eye. So, para magkaroon ng bigger structure, mag-bigger na clump, dalawa at least two na RBC sensitized with the IgG dapat ang present. Plus, kailangan mo siyang i-bind ang dalawa na to by addition of your anti-human globulin. So, anti-human globulin enhance agglutination reaction by cross-linking two or more RBC sensitized with an IgG. Pag sinabing sensitized, may nag-attach, sensitization is just attachment of your IgG to your RBC. Another potentiator, we have here the 22% albumin. So, the 22% albumin enhance agglutination reaction by adjusting your zeta potential. Remember that the zeta potential is the one responsible here for not allowing the RBC to come closer to one another. So, just need to destroy. So, ang ginagawa ni specifically nito ay we try to enhance by adjusting the zeta potential. Another one, we have the LISS. LISS stand here for low ionic strength saline solution. So, lower concentration of the saline at 0.2%. Usually kasi ang saline natin, your NSS, normal saline solution, ay nasa 0.85 to 0.9%. Your low ionic strength saline solution would have a concentration only of 0.2%. Paano naman nag-enhance ng agglutination reaction ang ating low ionic strength saline solution? Again, it try to allow the RBC here to come to one another or allowing the RBC to take up more antibody easily. So, it would immediately the RBC able to take up antibody easily, so it will easy for you then to enhance or to visualize your agglutination reaction. Another thing about addition of your low ionic strength saline solution, it also try to decrease the incubation time. Usually, incubation time natin pag gumagawa tayo nito ng mga, like for example, when you're doing your cross-matching procedure, to check here if the recipient would have an antibody corresponding to the donor's blood. Kung wala ka potentiators, the incubation time here as medyo matagal siya, 30 to 60 minutes. So, by addition of your LISS, it would have incubation time only reduced to 5 to 15 minutes. So, other reference, nagsasabi na 10 to 15 minutes. Pero at least, di ba, mabilis na incubation time, so mabilis ang test result and interpretation readings natin. Another one, we have your PEG, polyethylene glycol, or polybren, and polybren, so they just belong to the same family. Polybren, its main advantage, try to detect an APO incompatibility. It also try to detect an IgG isoagglutinins. Your polyethylene glycol, on the other hand, try to reduce here the occurrence of your false positive reaction and even mga non-specific untoward reactions. So, less prone to your false positive reactions. Ang pinaka-action ng ating polyethylene glycol to enhance agglutination reaction is by removing the water in the environment or your reactants. So, for example, itong mga RBC natin, okay, so, if this one is your test tube, may mga RBC tayo. Ang ginagawa ni polyethylene glycol, you try to remove the water dito. You call that one as your hydration theory. So, by removing the water, nawawala ng water, and eventually allowing the RBC to become concentrated, or, di ba, pag nawala ng water, So, magko-concentrate sila. And therefore, it would allow you to visualize or to enhance the agglutination reaction because of that.